Let us learn about brittle asthma today. Brittle asthma is a type of asthma distinguishable from other forms of asthma by recurrent severe attacks. There are two subtypes, type 1 and type 2. Depending on the stability of the patient's maximum speed of expiration or peak expiratory flow rate. Type 1 is characterized by sustained chronic variability of peak expiratory flow rate. Type 2 is characterized by sudden unpredictable drops in peak expiratory flow rate where asthma symptoms are otherwise well controlled and the function of lungs is not substantially impaired. Brittle asthma is one of the unstable subtypes of difficult to treat asthma, a term used to characterize the less than 5% of asthma cases that do not respond to maximal inhaled treatment, including high doses of steroids combined with additional therapies such as long acting beta 2 agonists like salmeterol, formoterol. Type 1. There is persistent daily chaotic variability in peak flow, usually more than 40% of diurnal variation in peak expiratory flow rate in more than 50% of the time. Type 2 is characterized by sudden sporadic falls in peak expiratory flow rate against the background of usually well-controlled asthma with normal or near-normal asthma and without an obvious trigger. In both types, patients are subjected to recurrent severe attacks. Individuals with type 1 suffer chronic attacks in spite of ongoing medical therapy, while those with type 2 experience sudden, acute, even life-threatening attacks, even though otherwise their asthma seems well managed. Brittle asthma, though found in all ages, most commonly found in individuals between 18 to 55 years. In type 1, 3 times more risky in females. Treatment of type 1, maximum dose of steroids either oral or in inhaled form plus beta 2 agonist and additional subcutaneous injection of beta 2 agonist like salmeterol and formoterol. Coming to treatment of type 2 brittle asthma, maximum doses of steroids either oral or inhaled and self-management approaches, allergen avoidance. In type 2 brittle asthma, since catastrophic attacks are unpredictable, patients may display identification of the issue such as medi-colored bracelet or carry an epinephrine auto-injector to prevent the sudden attacks. Thank you.